All right, buckle up, space enthusiasts. We've got some lunar gossip to spill. So, you have probably heard about India's recent feat, right? They officially joined the elite club of lunar landers, becoming the fourth country to gently touch down the moon's surface. Take a bow, Chandrayaan 3. But hang on, let's rewind a bit. Remember Chandrayaan 2? Yeah, that one that stumbled in 2019. Well, the clever minds at the Indian Space Research Organization took notes and came back stronger. This time, they nailed it. And guess what? They landed super close to the lunar south pole at approximately 69 degrees in latitude. Now hold on to your helmets, because it's not just about bragging rights. Oh no, this mission comes packing a rover named Pragyan. It's not just there to flaunt its wheels, it's there to party with science. The Pragyan rover is on a mission to collect and scrutinize lunar soil, kind of like an interstellar detective, and it's using something called spectroscopy to snoop around for various elements. Plus, there's another probe on board checking out plasma density on the lunar surface. Now, this is what you call multitasking, right? But don't get too attached, because the rover's solo mission lasts a mere 2 weeks. Mostly because it relies on solar panels. And with the lunar day being 2 weeks, it's assumed that it's going to be too cold for the rover to survive another 14 days long night. So that means by the time you are watching this video, Chandrayaan 3 has crossed half of its life. Without sun, it's unlikely to function afterwards. But what makes this mission particularly interesting is the total cost. The budget for this lunar adventure, a jaw-dropping $75 million. Yep, you heard that right. That's like pocket change compared to NASA's bills. Let's give India a well-deserving round of applause for their frugal fineness and the lunar touchdown. But here's the thing, folks. We might want to throw a race party for these scientists. Landing on the moon, there's no small feat. They deserve more than just a cosmic high five, don't you think? Because most of them are heavily underpaid. Keeping that aside, let's fast forward a bit. One of the main reasons this mission now succeeded is because of those specific lessons from 2019. For example, here, one thing they did differently is replacing 5 engines with just 4 in order to increase stability. It's now believed that it was the 5th engine that potentially caused the lander's collision back in 2019. But even though India has now become the 4th country, the 5th country might be Japan. This one right here, JAXA's slim lander, is most likely going to be the next contender. Also developed based on previous lessons from the previous crash. But the biggest mission planned for next year is going to be NASA's Viper. That's going to be launched in November 2024. So it looks like the moon race might have started once again. But we'll see how all of this goes in the next few years. Previously, the failure of Hakuto R lander by Japan, which basically crashed on the moon, and Israel's Bereshit lander that also crashed there as well. But we can also add Luna 25 to this list, the Russian attempt after approximately 47 years. And that really doesn't look good for Roscosmos. Oh well, too bad. Now, speaking of lunar landers, China's Chang'e 4 mission did a lunar dance of its own. It landed a rover in the mysterious U2 region. And guess what? The rover got curious and started digging deep, up to 300 meters. It's like the moon's very own archaeological dig. What did they find? Layers upon layers of ancient lunar history, my friend. It was able to visualize various layers underneath the lunar regolith by using what's known as LPR. Now, they previously tried this back in 2020, but only up to 40 meters. But this time, they were able to do this much, much deeper. First, uncovering the information about the upper surface crater produced by an asteroid smacking into this area. But then, discovering 5 distinct layers showing different types of lunar lava. Now, there's a history lesson with lunar twists. Now, because the moon does not have plate tectonics and because everything here just stays on the surface, by going deeper and deeper into the lunar surface, we are going back in time. So, here it was possible to see several billion years into the past. But obviously, this is just the first such analysis and the first such study. A lot more will probably be uncovered in the next few years. I had made a very detailed video about this a couple of months back. No one really watched it. So, please go and watch that after watching this video. Alright, back on Earth for a second. You won't believe what scientists are up to. They've got their hands on lunar soil and they're cooking something incredible. Using lasers and some serious science magic, they're extracting oxygen from lunar dirt. Imagine setting up a moon base with oxygen from, well, the moon. This is like science fiction becoming reality, and it's not even April Fool's Day. But hold on folks, we have got a lunar dust buster situation in our hand. That lunar dust, sharp and clingy as your favorite pairs of socks on laundry day, is causing a ruckus. It's not just a tiny annoyance, it's a big, bad hazard. Inhale it and your lungs are in for a moon-sized surprise. And let's not forget the lunar dust storms that could turn your fancy lunar outposts into a gritty sandcastle. Yep, even our future lunar gateway might face the wrath of the lunar dust devil. Sadly, we don't have a solution for that yet. Phew. Who knew the moon had so many surprises, right? And trust me, this is just the beginning. So if you are excited as a rocket on launch day, hit that subscribe button and join our cosmic crew. We're exploring the universe one discovery at a time. Meanwhile, watch this video. As per China, moon may have a cosmic solution for all our energy problems. Thanks for hanging out, space fans. Stay curious, stay stellar. And keep your eyes on the skies and keep wondering.